The Islanders are headed to the playoffs after another strong performance. They kind of rolled Thursday's effort right into this one.
They really did, and when you look at the Buffalo Sabres, you're thinking, yeah, that's the way the game should be played. If the Islanders get on their toes and play with the same commitment as we saw in Winnipeg, then the score should be what it was, and there was no disappointments from anybody. I mean, Barry Trotz is going to be very happy, very pleased with the commitment by his team, as well as the fans. I mean, they played a solid 60-minute game. There was no let-ups. They were going right till the end, so they're getting themselves ready. They're certainly heading in the right direction for the playoffs.
And they're tuning up for Monday when they'll see John Tavares and the Toronto Maple Leafs in the final home game of the regular season. Let's talk about this one, though. The Islanders came out, talk about rolling in from Thursday. Really, from the opening shift, they were all over the Buffalo Sabres.
Well, they started the right line, no doubt about it. Of course, Barry does that on most occasions. And the Cizikas line took it right to the Sabres and established the way the game ought to be played. And certainly Jordan Eberle, that's the second shift, but it was the Cizikas line that started the ball rolling. And then the good dazzle, razzle-dazzle by our guy, yes, Matt Barzal. But it's Jordan Eberle who uses the skate, kicks it up and scores. And now the Islanders are off and running. And that probably, for me, Brennan, was maybe the most important goal of the game. The first goal, it established the position and the ability to just kind of pull away a little bit. And Anthony, with his speed, talking about pulling away, is able to get a penalty shot. Wasn't successful, but he wasn't going to be deterred tonight. There was no doubt about it. This is a successful first period for the Islanders, coming away with a lead.
It could have been worse than the 1-0 lead that it was for the Buffalo Sabres. Jordan Eberle continues his hot streak. He scored two out of the final three goals on Thursday. He picks up his fourth goal in the last four games. His 18 on the year now with three games to go, trying to keep that 20-goal scoring streak intact. Well, Anthony Beauvillier missed that penalty shot attempt. It was just about 5 minutes after the Islanders had taken a 1-0 lead. You talked about it. He would not be deterred. He finished this game with a couple of goals. He got one in the second period.
Well, played one of his better games, I thought. And obviously, you know, you look at stats and you know, you say, okay, there's certain aspects of the stats or the goals that I want to get to. And certainly 20 goals is a very important factor for him. And he's able to zip this one by. It's a big goal for the Islanders because it gave them a 2-0 lead. But missing all of that was the move by this man here, Taze, as he was out a long time, recognizing there was a tired Buffalo team, so he took a few more chances, and Anthony was the recipient of the finish in the whole play. And then this goal here by Dal Cole right at the end of the third period, Brendan, big goal.
In the final 30 seconds, it went off Dal Cole's leg, back into Hutton. It winds up in the back of the net, and so the Islanders jump out to a 3-0 lead after two periods, and you could smell where this one was going after that as he scores his goal on three shots, just three goals this season, but in 26 games as he continues to try and solidify his spot on this NHL roster heading into the postseason.
Well, he's getting better and better. And you know, I talked to him actually today, too, as I was in the dressing room. And we were smiling and talking about goal scoring and stuff like that. And I said, hey, you don't care how many you score as long as you score, right? And he says, yeah, I'll take one tonight. So it worked out well for him. But he's a much improving player. And you're right, he just does not want to get out of the lineup. You don't get many chances. Barry said, hey, next man up attitude. Well, he doesn't want a next man attitude. He wants to stay.
Islanders were in pretty good control of this hockey game after two, but they had scored in the final minute of the second. And then you score on the opening shift of the third, and they were in control. Ryan Pulock got another one for the Islanders.
Well, that was about six nails in the coffin of the Buffalo team. If they had any visions of coming back, they're the ones that wanted to score early in the third period. But we witnessed again, it's the Cizikas line that goes to work down low, and the battle in front eliminates both defensemen. And it's Ryan Pulock who makes a beautiful move, forehand move. We've seen this one, likes to go to this forehand, gets it head up all the way and then picks his spot. And for all intents and purposes, the game is over now. The Islanders lead 4-0.
But it wasn't over yet. Anthony Beauvillier still wanted another one as he picks up his second of the game.
Yeah, he's not ready to quit. And this is as pretty a three-way passing play as you're going to see at any point in time. Protects the puck, Komarov out to Josh Bailey. And that was smooth. I'll tell you what, that was so smooth. And Anthony knew where that puck was going. Yeah, over the goal line. And just a great effort from the Islanders. And good for Anthony. He's sniffing 20 now. So you got two guys that'll be going hard for the next, what is it, four games?
Three. All they have is three left, as Beauvillier has 18 now with his sixth career two-goal game, his first goal since the early part of March. And the Islanders finished March with a 9-7 record. It had some bumps along the way, but they are out like a lion or in like a lion. What are they doing? They're on their way.
They were out like a lamb and coming in like a lion.